This is Autoline Daily, the show dedicated to enthusiasts of the global automotive industry. Ford pulled the wraps off the all-electric F-150 Lightning last night. Its distinctive style is highlighted by an LED light strip that connects the two headlamps together. Behind that lighting is a massive frunk, which is expected to have 400 liters of space, the ability to carry 400 pounds, as well as four electrical outlets and two USB chargers. The interior also features the Mach-E's giant center display screen. But now let's get to the good stuff. All models come standard with four-wheel drive thanks to dual electric motors. Ford says it's targeting output of 563 horsepower and 775 pound-feet of torque for models with the larger battery pack. That should also return a 0 to 60 time in the mid-4-second range, and it will also allow a maximum of 10,000 pounds to be towed. Models with the standard battery pack have a max payload of 2,000 pounds. Ford didn't reveal sizes for those battery packs, but estimates a range of 230 miles for the smaller pack and 300 for the larger. Production kicks off next year, and pricing starts at nearly $40,000 for entry-level models before incentives, while a mid-level XLT will start just below $53,000. And speaking of Ford and EVs, it's securing the battery supplies it needs. Ford and SK Innovation have reached an agreement to build batteries in the U.S., and this move was made possible by a settlement between SK and rival battery maker LG Chem. LG sued SK for stealing trade secrets, which resulted in an import ban for SK, but it's going to avoid that by paying LG $1.8 billion. The batteries that come out of SK's U.S. plant in Georgia will be used in the new F-150 Lightning. EV startup Faraday Future is showing off some of the rear seat features in its FF91 vehicle. Passengers back there can lower and raise a roof-mounted 27-inch display screen with AI-enhanced voice commands. It's also equipped with in-cabin cameras that support video conferencing, and the rear display can mirror the rider's phone as well. Faraday is preparing to go public through a SPAC merger that's expected to close in the second quarter of the year. The company is aiming to launch the FF91 within 12 months of that merger.
Autoline supports the automotive industry because it's such a job-creating machine. From the shop floor to the boardroom, the auto industry generates tens of thousands of jobs on every social-economic level, including designers, engineers, technicians, machinists, programmers, you name it. No other industry employs so many people in so many different jobs. And that's why we're proud to say that Autoline is an advocate for the automotive industry.
We want to know what drives your testing. OTA, connected car, diagnostics, remote testing. Intrepid Control Systems is here to help you work from anywhere. Intrepid Control Systems, driven by your data.
Electrion, a company that's developing inductive in-road charging, is collaborating with Stellantis, Iveco, and a number of other partners to test wireless charging. The project will see the construction of a closed beltway, a little over a half a mile in length, near Milan, Italy. Electrion will install its technology in two Stellantis electric vehicles, but the models weren't disclosed, and an Iveco bus. And will demonstrate inductive in-road charging while vehicles are stationary, like at a toll booth, as well as charging while the vehicles are in motion. The project will also look at the best way to install the system so roads remain durable while not impacting the performance of the technology. Revealing that it's under investigation from the SEC made headlines earlier this week, But Canoe also announced pricing for its cool-looking people mover, or what it calls the lifestyle vehicle. Base models come in at a little under $35,000 before incentives, and prices go up to about $50,000. Anyone that's interested can plunk down a $100 deposit right now. But, as we noted the other day, there's been a number of negative reports around Canoe recently, and its stock price has been cut by two-thirds since December. ZF and Mobileye will develop advanced driver assistance systems for Toyota. It wasn't revealed what vehicles will be installed with the technology, but it will be used in, quote, multiple vehicle platforms. Mobileye's IQ4 chip for autonomous driving will be combined with ZF's Gen 21 mid-range technology, which will help the vehicle to understand the environment around it. The system is designed to meet 2022 Euro NCAP 5-star safety ratings and enable Level 2 automated driving functions like pedestrian detection, automatic emergency braking, and adaptive cruise control.
Mobility is becoming electric, connected, and autonomous, just like the manufacturing world. But we'll always be one thing, a reliable partner for our customers.
Automakers are embracing the use of more sustainable materials in their vehicles. And now BMW is the first manufacturer to use tires made from sustainable natural rubber and rayon, a wood-based material that's used to strengthen the tires. The 22-inch tires, made and developed by Pirelli, will be available this August for the plug-in hybrid version of the X5. The tires will be made exclusively at Pirelli's plant in Rome, Georgia, then shipped to BMW's plant in Spartanburg, South Carolina, to have them installed on the X5 plug-in. The performance version of the Acura TLX, the Type S, is about to arrive at dealerships in the U.S. It goes on sale June 23rd with a starting price of just over $53,000, including destination charges. It's powered by a 3-liter V6 that cranks out 355 horsepower and is mated to a 10-speed automatic transmission. Its fuel economy is 21 mpg combined. The chassis features a double wishbone suspension, adaptive dampers, and the braking system from the NSX. If you're interested, Acura just launched a site where you can build and price your own and contact a dealer to reserve one. But you better act quick. Only 2,000 will be built for the 2021 model year. And hey, we've got a great AutoLine After Hours this afternoon. Joining John and Gary will be Eric Noble from the Car Lab and Sam Fiorani from Auto Forecast Solutions. Some of the topics they'll tackle include, would Americans want to buy a Hongguang mini EV? Will OEMs become tech companies before tech companies become OEMs? Did COVID kill car sharing? Will EVs have hockey stick growth? And will OEMs price themselves out of the market? I don't know how they're going to manage to get it all in, but it all gets going at 3 p.m. Eastern Time, and you're invited to join us. That's it for today's show. Thanks for watching.
AutoLine Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone, solutions for your journey, Intrepid Control Systems, over-the-air engineering, boost your game, Scheffler, we pioneer motion, and by Magna.